visualization of the event history. It's a very critical part of hazard health monitoring and maintenance. Okay, I'll explain a bit more in detail about what this exactly means. So around 4 years back in 2016, you might have heard about this incident. So there was this aircraft of Pakistani International Airlines, which crashed and all 47 people on board were killed. And there was also a Pakistani pop star among the victims. So what had actually happened was the pilot made a mayday call saying he had lost control of one of the two engines. Okay. And similarly, last year, this you might be familiar. So you know this Indigo Airlines, right? So they have this fleet of an aircraft called Airbus A320neo. And several aircraft had this engine failure, but thankfully none of them crashed or there was no accident, thankfully. But after several such incidents happened, there was this notification issued by the DGCA. So India threatens to ground Airbus jets after a string of engine failures. And so this is the thing. So Indigo won't be allowed to fly A320neo jets fitted with two 1100 production series engine. So the 1100 is nothing but the number of the engine made by a particular manufacturer. So if the engine has been in operation for more than 3000 hours, then it won't be allowed to fly on the aircraft. So that was the ruling that was issued by the DGCA. So in the first incident, right, 4 years back, I was involved with one of the stakeholders in this thing. Definitely not PAA. I'm an Indian by heart, by soul. So what had happened was, for the engine fleet, they said they need a visual representation on the history of each engine. But by history, what we mean is the sequence of events that have happened over the life of... Okay, so these were basically the news articles that I was talking about. And in 4 years back, I was involved with one of the stakeholders in this particular incident. And there the situation was that the client said they needed a visual representation on the history of each engine made by them. Okay. And by history, what I mean is the sequence of events that have happened over the life of the engine, since the time of the manufacturer to the current time. So it's like, for example, when you buy a car or a bike, they say that after the first 1,000 kilometers, you bring it for the first free service. Then after 5,000 kilometers, you bring it for the next service. Then after 10,000 kilometers, you bring it for the third service. So over the span of 1 year, for 5,000 kilometers, 5,000 kilometers, 10,000 kilometers, you take it for service. So similarly, for aircraft engines also, it happens. But the lifespan is measured in terms of hours. So that's why if you see here in this article, so they are saying more than 3,000 hours. So it's like every 3,000 hours or every X number of hours, you have to perform some maintenance. That's how it usually happens. Okay. So now the question boils down to, how do we visualize history? Because what they are asking for is visual representation on the history of each engine. Okay. So let's talk about how do we visualize history. Typically, if you see, you know, you take any magazine or a newspaper, they have something called as an infographic. Okay. And visualization of a history is usually done in the form of a timeline. So for example, if you take the timeline of India's independence movement, we can say that it starts from 1857. Of course, there were efforts going on much before that as well, but largely 1857, the Great Revolt of 1857, is taken as the catalyst for setting us on the path towards independence. And then you have certain key events. So 1918, you have the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, then civil disobedience movement, certain other events. And finally, 1947, we achieved independence. So over the course of the 90 years, from 1857 to 1947, so what are the key events that have happened over the history of the country? Okay. So applying the same analogy to this aircraft engine history scenario, one thing to note here is that every asset or every engine, so by asset here I mean it could be an engine, it could be a generator, elevator, escalator, whatever. So any kind of an asset or a machine has a lifespan or a service time. Okay? And different maintenance activities are performed over this lifespan. So what are these different maintenance activities? So for example, typically if you take an aircraft industry, you have something called as a maintenance, repair and overhaul. So maintenance is nothing but regular maintenance that you perform. So after every flight, once the aircraft has landed, they perform some regular checks of checks and maintenance. So some parts of the engine are subjected to more wear and tear, and when the aircraft is flying at a very high speed, some of the parts might be subjected to excessive amount of force or velocity or whatever. So that is the regular maintenance. And then you have some repair. So if any part has malfunctioned, or if any part has has experienced a problem, then you replace that part or repair that part. So that is the repair part of MRO. And then you have something called overhaul, which is like a complete revamp of the engine. So this aircraft engine, if you see, it does predominantly what you call as life limited parts. So every part has to be replaced X number of hours. So for example, if you are owning a car, they say that after 30,000 kilometers or after 50,000 kilometers, you need to replace the tires, right? So similarly, you have the life limited parts in the engine as well. And when you replace all those parts, and you know, when you put in all the new parts over there, so that's what is typically referred to as an overhaul. Okay. So how do we visualize this kind of a engine history? That's what I would like to show you today. So what you see here on the screen, right? So we have something called as an asset at the left, asset one, asset two. So like I said, the asset could be an engine or a generator or any kind of a machine. And over the course of time, right? So from July 2016 to, let's say, April 2017, we have something called as the lifespan of the asset. So here I've just taken as asset working hours is 10,000. I've just assumed that each asset has been operating for 10,000 hours. Okay. And over the course of this 10,000 hours, some activities have been performed on this asset. So the X mark indicates a failure. The exclamation mark indicates a warning. This spanner icon indicates a minor maintenance activity that has been carried out. And this person icon indicates a major maintenance activity. Okay. And if you just hover over this icon, it also shows you at what date and time the activity was carried out during the lifespan of the engine. Okay. And how will this data look like? It looks something like this. So this is how you your raw data looks like. So you have the asset ID, and then you have the date or the timestamp, and then you have the event type, whether it's a warning, failure, minor maintenance or major maintenance. And for each asset, you have also have the working hours. Now let's show you how we can make this visualization. Let's create a new chart. It's a very simple viz actually. So what you do is you just drag and drop this asset ID onto rows, and then you drag and drop this date onto the columns. Make it as a continuous measure. Since we have data at a timestamp level, if you see here, so this is actually at a timestamp level. So I'll just say, up to a second, okay. And then you have the asset working hours. And this we will make as an attribute, because every asset will have a particular working hour. So asset one, if you see, so I mean, here I would just put everything as 10,000 since this is a dummy data, but every asset will typically have some lifespan or some operating hours. That's what we put here. And this cannot be a sum because I'm changing it to an attribute, because each asset has multiple rows here, and so sum won't be the right measure to look at, because since each row corresponds to a particular event that has happened over the course of the asset, I'm just taking the attribute of this asset working hours for each asset. And what I do is I click on this and change this to a bar, okay, and click here. Let's make this as a dual axis, okay, and just some minor touches here. What I do is we have this event types, right? The maintenance activity or the failure or the warning, so whatever that is, I will just change this to a shape, and I will just drag this event type and drop it onto the shapes box here, and just remove this color. Yeah, just make this a bit bigger so that it's more clearly visible.
Uh, Sai, you can give this Insta standard interview. That will work like this.
Yeah. Thanks, Yash.
Yeah.
This is so, and then you can just make some small aesthetic adjustments. You go, just to enhance the visual appearance of this thing. What you can do is you can just reduce the size of this bar. Now, this will kind of look more like a timeline. So, for example, what we saw on the slide right here. So, on a particular timeline, you have notations for the events. So, similarly, if you want, you can just reduce the thickness of the bar here so that it looks like a line, and you can increase the size of this shape here. And one more thing that you can possibly do is you can reduce the opacity of this so that the symbols stand out a bit more clearly. Okay, so this is how you get to the visualization. Now, one interesting thing to note here is that the symbols that you see here won't be available by default in Tableau. Okay, so what we do is you just click on edit shape here, and so typically after you have installed Tableau, you will get all this default filled arrows, bars, bug tracking and everything. But you see here there is something called as a maintenance. Okay, this is something that you might not have in your Tableau by default, and this is what we call as custom shapes in Tableau. So you see these icons are the icons that you see here are what the same as what we see on this visualization here. So how did we get these icons? So what you do is, so once you install Tableau, right, you go to My Documents and you will have this folder called as My Tableau Repository. Okay, so you open this folder, and inside this you will have one more folder called as Shapes. Open the Shapes. Typically, so the default shapes that you have in Tableau, so the arrows, bars, bug tracking, gender, so these are all the predefined shapes in Tableau, and you can see that each shape set has a particular folder. So what you do is you create a new folder here. So you see this maintenance. This is what I have created, and inside this maintenance folder, I have just downloaded these icons from the internet and I've pasted them here. Simple. That's it. One thing to note here is the icon should be in the PNG format. It only then you can use it in Tableau. If it is in the JPG format, you can't use it. So just take care that these are in the PNG format. So once you put your icons or pictures here, then once you have created the folder and pasted the icons, you will automatically get these details over here. And just click on OK. And that's how you get this viz here. Any questions here so far?
All good from my side.
See, so this is, I would say, one part of our visualization, right? So what other insights can we get from this kind of data? See, visualization is one part, and this particular piece that we saw, though it looks interesting, it's a different way of looking at the data. And if you add some other pieces of complementary tables or information to the same visualization, then you will be able to enhance your the power of your dashboard. Okay, so that's what I've said here. The viz can be further enhanced by providing service activity details in the tooltip. So for example, here you just hover on this, right? So it says failure. For example, if you have the data, you can paste that data in the tooltip regarding what was the exact failure that has occurred, what was the part that failed. Or for example, if it's a maintenance activity, then what maintenance activity was carried out. So all those details, if you put it here, then it will give you a lot more detail. So just like what we saw in this Indian independence visualization. So you can put all these details in the tooltip. And then the additional things that you can get from this kind of data is something called as a mean time between failure. Okay, so typically when you talk about any data, you have something called as key performance indicators or KPIs, right? So when you're working on events data or equipment related data, this is one very important KPI, mean time between failure. So if this mean time between failure is a frequency of how often the failure occurs. Okay, and if this mean time between failure is higher, it means that the asset is more reliable. It won't fail very often. That's the definition. And the other information that you can get is some points like this. X percentage of the time, event A was followed by event B. Y percentage of the time, event A was followed by a failure. And something like after event B occurs, the 90th percentile of the time to failure is N hours, like that. Okay. So how do you get this kind of information? So this is typically your raw data. And what you do is you just create one additional column saying next event. Okay. And so if you take this asset one, first event is warning and next event will be this failure. And then take this asset two, first event is warning, next event is minor maintenance. And then the next event after this minor maintenance is failure. And after failure, next event is major maintenance. So you add this kind of an additional column and you try to enhance the data. And once you have this column, you get these kinds of points, what I have listed here. So in how much percentage of the time maintenance activity was followed by a failure. So this could mean something like whatever maintenance I did was not effective because it anyway resulted in a failure. So these kinds of insights you can get. Of course, the visualization component here is very simple. That's why I have not put it in Tableau, because you know, these things you can get it as a table itself. But my point here is that you have this visualization already, and you make a dashboard with this visualization and also combine the event sequence and those percentage details, and that will further enhance the power of your visualization. And once you have everything in place on your dashboard, you can actually use it to configure an early warning system, like what we have in the weather, right? So for example, you have something called a tsunami early warning system. So how that works is like something like this. So they have devices or sensors on the surface of the ocean, which measure the velocity of the waves, the height of the waves, and all those things. And based on those signatures, they will be transmitting the data to the weather station, which warns the people in advance. So similarly, if you are able to look at information in this format, so what percentage of the time event A was followed by event B. So if you are able to look at these event signatures, then you can set your or configure your system in such a way that N hours after a particular event has occurred, it is likely to fail, so that the system can issue an alarm in advance. So the bottom line here is you have this event history visualization already, which we just made, and you add these complementary tables based on the event signatures, and you get this event history dashboard, which you can use to take proactive decisions. Now, this is something that I have recounted from my experience, and believe me, this has this is a tried and tested formula, which is followed by many companies which are in this particular business. So yeah, that's what I had for today.